Alrighty, so yeah, I haven't made the videos about the guruing for a while. I guess it's just a major observance, like a counter effect that's been going on for many years. And I'll try to bring it to an analogy. Okay, so here you are. You're in a hurry. You're going down the road, and you have to do something very quickly. And it's like other people don't want you to, and yet you have to. But it's like their forces have become so great and compounding that there'll be extra traffic blocking your way, and you're like, but I have to get there, I have to get there, I have to hurry. But then there'll be extra traffic, slower and slower and slower, and so you're like, what's going on? It's like I'm walking through a dream that, you know, you're like running in place and you never get there. So it's like this, the flow is interrupted, you know, your life flow has been interrupted by all of these counter forces that are aggregates, or they're pushing out through their minds, no, we don't want you to do that, no, we don't want you to do that, no, we don't want you to do that. And so thusly there's traffic constantly in front of that small little attempt, the small little place that I had chosen to go or was headed towards. And conversely, on those days when there is no rush and there's no have to, there's no counter argument of your place or your position or your way, on those days the flow is going. The flow is going fine. There's no interruption. There's no block. There's no blockage. So I'm like thinking about all these blockages that people are like pushing and submitting, you know, through their brains. Block at her, block at him, block, block, block. You know, we're just blocking people all the time. And so I'm like, well, the flow, when we get to the flow, talking about the flow of nature, the natural flow, watching some wildlife videos, the natural flow, just like a wild animal, it is not trained, it's not coming from a judgment zone of have to and schedule. In the wild, it's different, isn't it? It's just the natural flow of doing. So here you are, you're like, well, I'm going to A, point A, and I'm going to point B. Okay, so there's no interruption in that flow. In the wild, there isn't. Unless there's maybe like a wild animal that comes there and gets in the way and you have to fight it. If you were a wild animal, so those types of things would happen. But in civilization, well, you could go and say, well, the wild animal's the same as that extra wild animal's the same as the cars blocking you. You could say that. Okay, I'll listen to that for a moment. But really, I was trying to get to the flow of nature, how you're at the point A going to B, and there is no major, like, hey, you know, contra event in front of you. There's no, you know, very rare instances, perhaps. Yeah, because, you know, you're a wild animal, you could be walking the planet for 40 years, and then all of a sudden you're attacked by another. So, yeah, it would be a very unusual circumstance. But in civilization, it appears that we're just getting these I don't want to just say a traffic block, because this is not just about traffic, but all kinds of additional walls are being brought up. You know, there's another wall. I'm like, oh my gosh, another wall, you know. Either a wall in a person's thinking, a wall in a public group and their way of thinking, a wall. You're like, oh my gosh, how could that happen? How could they all think that way? It just is impossible, you know. Because back into the wild, we're just A, going to point B. And we're meandering in that flow. And there's not an interruption. You know, just look at a cat out there in the Serengeti. He's just taking a walk. You know, he sees what he wants and he goes and gets it. And there's not the interruption in the flow. But in civilization, in the civilization that we have, we are interrupted, aren't we? And I believe the more and more we are interrupted as people, that civilization itself will implode upon itself. It will be like a collapse event. Like here is, you know, you were just trying, you have all these people trying to do A to B, you know, in their lives. But they're all getting blocked. It's not a success. It's not a succeed event. It is a fail. So realistically, the success event is the wild, is nature and the wild. Because the interruption event really only happens, really only occurs in that, like, hey, you know, this is your last day, pal. You know, if you're that cat walking and along comes in a saber tooth that's bigger than you, you know, only then is that your last day. All the days preceding, you were free. You know, you were free in your flow. So this is why I believe that civilization will not make it. We will fight it, we will fight it, we will fight it. But on a human scale, 1 to 1 to 1 to 1, we have way too many forces against. Way too many forces against. So anyway, so that was really what I wanted to get out today, was that discussion. Did I write it all down? The one wild, the cause and effect. Yeah, the implosion of civilization. Now, why is it going to implode? I know I sound like one of those, you know, oh my gosh, cool, we have one of those, is this those black flag events or something? No, nothing like that. But we're going to implode because we are having too many blocks. You have a block, I have a block, that person over there has a block. We're just having blocks, you know, walls, just... We're riddled with walls in front of our steps. You know, you have to walk that path that is the current guideline, or else. If you do not walk that path, and I will say that path, that very thin path, that is approved by those people that are your friendships or your acquaintances. They're sending energy out to you, even if they're your enemies. They're sending energy out to you in your direction. Now, I don't know about how fear goes, like when they, you know, you're in a kind of a fear and a panic state, if it just leeches on and so more blocks happen, you know, you release fear or panic, and those signals, those telecommunication signals they're sending through their brainwaves in the air, you know, how powerful those are. You know, once you are feeling fear and panic, how powerful, you know, to make that wall and that block even stronger. Those walls build up even higher. It's like, well, I really wanted to go that way, but clunk, 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 clunk. It's not going to happen anymore. Not in my life. I've had, like, them say no, and these ones think that, and these other ones go ye. And I'm like, well, I might as well not even be here. I have so much in the negative. So I'm like, well, so you can walk and dance and prance in how they want. How they want, and their tight fiddle, you can play it, but it's not your true self. It's not going to be your wild A to B. It's not going to be how you are going to strut your life through, is it? So yeah, so we're dealing with these forces of the others. The forces of the others. Anyway, my video went.